If you are a Christian, open up. You will know about God and the Jewish. 144 different references about God. What do you want to know about justice, about creation? What do you want to know? Jesus. And the J, you see Jesus in the index. Number one, first item is a righteous prophet. He is a true prophet of God. Chapter 6, verse 85. Second item, his birth, described in two places. Chapter 3, verses 45 onwards. Chapter 19, verses 23 onwards. Let's see now what it says. Naturally, you want to know, what does it say? Actually, open the book. Chapter 3, verse 42. You open. I read it for you in Arabic, and I'll give you the translation. This is what it says. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. In the name of God, most gracious, most merciful. وَإِذْ قَالَتِ الْمَلَائِكَةُ يَا مَرْيَمُ وَإِذْ قَالَتِ الْمَلَائِكَةُ يَا مَرْيَمُ So behold, the angel said, O Mary, you know Mary, the mother of Jesus. يَا مَرْيَمُ إِنَّ اللَّهَ اسْتَفَاكِ وَتَحَرَكِ وَاسْتَفَاكِ عَلَى نِسَاءِ الْعَالَمِينَ Don't worry about the Arabic. Don't worry about the Arabic. You just read the English. Behold, the Behold, the angel said, O Mary, God has chosen thee and purified thee, chosen thee above the women of all nations. You're reading the Quran now, not the Bible. This is the Quran talking. God Almighty has chosen Mary, the mother of Jesus, above the women of all nations. And if you read that, suppose the Arabic was not there, and you found these pages strewn around. I can take an oath that in 1,000 years you'll never guess you're reading the Quran. In 1,000 years, you'll never guess you're reading the Quran. You'll think maybe this is the Roman Catholic version if you haven't seen one. Maybe this is the... By God, this is what you'll think. That man, this is so near to your heart. It is so near to... I'm talking to the Christian now. It's so close to your heart that you can never imagine the Quran, you're reading the Quran. He says, maybe this is, as I said, the Roman Catholic version. Maybe this is the Greek Orthodox version. Maybe this is the New World Translation of the Jehovah's Witnesses. And on, but you'll never guess you're reading the Quran. You know why? Because at the back of the mind, we Muslims are anti-Christ. We are the enemies of Christ. So you expect these things to come from the Quran? Never! See, so he said, no, it can't be the Quran, must be anything else but the Quran. But you are reading the Quran. That this book of God makes us to accept Jesus Christ, that he was one of the mightiest messengers of God. We are made to believe that he was the Messiah. Messiah, translated Christ. That he was born miraculously, without any male intervention, which many modern day Christians don't believe today. Including the Anglican bishops. More than 50% of the Anglican bishops in England, they do not believe in the miraculous birth of Jesus. We Muslims, we believe. Without any arguments from the Christians, we accept that he was born miraculously, without any male intervention. We believe that he gave life to the dead by God's permission, and he healed those born blind and the lepers by God's permission, on the authority of this book. No arguments. The Muslim will never argue with you with regards to these things. So no, we believe, we believe, we believe, we believe. Yes, sir.
What about Christ's resurrection as the
believe? Yes. So now, the question is, what about Christ's resurrection? Meaning, death and resurrection. That he died and he was resurrected. Now, here is the point of difference. The point of real difference is the divinity. But now, this is secondary. But I have to deal with it. You ask the question. What about the resurrection? The Quran says, وَمَا قَتَلُوهُ With regards to that point, وَمَا قَتَلُوهُ وَمَا صَلَبُوهُ That they didn't kill him and they didn't crucify him. وَلَكِنْ شُبِّيَ لَهُمْ But it was made to appear to them. So, that is what they thought they had done. وَإِنَّ الَّذِينَ اخْتَلَفُوا فِيهِ لَفِي شَقٍ مِّنْهُمْ And those who dispute therein are full of doubts. مَا لَهُمْ بِهِ مِنْ عِلْمٍ They have no certain knowledge. إِلَّا تِبَزَّنْ They have only conjecture to follow. وَمَا قَتَلُوهُ يَقِينًا For a surety they killed him not. But now comes the problem. The problem is, then naturally the Christian said, look, but my book says so. It's in my Bible. Am I right, sir? He said, look, Matthew, Mark, Luke, John, they all testified that Christ was crucified and he rose again on the third day and on and he was taken up into heaven. So now the Muslim said, look, but my book says this. So you said, look, your book is false. Then I say, your book is false. No, there is no way. You see, that way, You know, it's like a tug of war. You know, we are going to start throwing mud at each other. No, we are not to do that. We said, now let us see now what makes us to think the way we are thinking. On the first hand, we say, because God says so. But he said, look, this is not the book of God. Where did you get it? He said, well, Muhammad was inspired. He said, look, we don't accept that. So therefore, my book, the Quran, tells me to ask you for your proof. The book says, anybody makes any claim, you ask him for his proof. Kul hatu burhanakum. That's what the Quran says. You produce your proof. So you produced it, the Bible, in 2,000 different languages. English, Afrikaans, Zulu, Urdu, Arabic, 2,000 different languages there, your proof. So I said, let's have a look at it. So when I read it, I'm going to just give you an example. That I'm reading your book in your language. English is a foreign language to me. I'm an Indian, born in India. You see, I acquired this English from your people. I learned this language and I'm now sharing it with you, your language. So I said, now I'm reading the Bible in English. And it's giving me an idea exact opposite of what you're telling me. I'm going to present it to you, sir. He said, you see, Jesus, when he returned to that upper room, where they had the Last Supper, after his alleged crucifixion, you know the scene. In Luke chapter 24, we read that he returns to that upper room and he wishes his disciples in Hebrew, Shalom Aleichum. We Muslims say Salam Aleikum, same, meaning the same thing, peace be unto you. Frida Fayala. And when he said peace be unto you, his disciples were terrified. So I'm asking, why were they terrified? Because if you meet your long-lost master, your uncle, your grandfather, the Arab and the Jew, he embraces one another, he kisses one another. Instead of doing that, the disciples of Jesus were terrified. So I'm asking, why were they terrified? So the learned man tells me that Luke chapter 24 verse 36, he says that they were frightened because they thought he was a spirit. I'm quoting, they thought he was a spirit. So I'm asking, why did they think he's a spirit? Did he look like a spirit? And everybody says no. Then why should they think the man is a spirit when he didn't look like a spirit? Puzzled. So I will tell you, sir, the reason. I said, you see, the disciples of Jesus, they had heard from hearsay, people talking that the master was hanged on the cross. They had heard from hearsay, people talking that he had given up the ghost. In other words, the spirit had come out, he had died. They had heard from hearsay, people talking that he's not dead and buried for 3 days. Because Mark chapter 14 verse 50, he tells us that at the most critical juncture in the life of Jesus, all his disciples forsook him and fled. All. Al-mal hum farlat and khaflak. All forsook him and they fled. So I'm asking, is it true? The Bible says they all forsook him and they fled. That means they were not there. Their knowledge was from hearsay, people talking. So on hearsay knowledge, if you know about a man who's dead and buried for 3 days, you expect him to be stinking in his grave after 3 days. So when you see such a person, naturally you're terrified. You're terrified. So Jesus wants to assure them that it's not what they're thinking. So he says, and I'm quoting, he says, behold my hands and my feet. Have a look at my hands and my feet, that it is I, myself. I'm the same fellow man. Damn fools, what are you afraid of before? What's wrong with you? Handle me and see. Handle me and see. For a spirit has no flesh and bones as you see me have. A spirit means any spirit would have no flesh and bones as you see me have. So, if I got flesh and bones, in that case, I'm not a spirit, I'm not a ghost, I'm not a spook. In your language, what does it mean? So, if I got flesh and bones, then I'm not what you're thinking. You're thinking I'm a spirit, a ghost, a resurrected, I'm not that. And they felt him, I'm reading, and believed not for joy, because they were overjoyed. Naturally, anticlimax. They thought the man was dead and buried, he's gone, but he's here. And they felt him and they believed not for joy and wondered. What happened, man? So to assure them further, he said, have you here any meat, something to eat? And they gave him a piece of broiled fish and a honeycomb. And he took it and he ate in the very sight to prove what? There is a ghost, is a spirit, is a spook. What is he trying to prove? So he said, you see, sir, this is programming. We all get brainwashed from childhood into certain beliefs, and we